Good evening and welcome to worship on this Good Friday evening. Tonight we are having the service of shadows and pray that this worship and this time is an opportunity for you to meditate and think about and really just receive the gift of God's grace given as Jesus gives himself for us. So may this evening be a blessing to you as you contemplate the gift of grace in Jesus Christ. You downloaded the bulletin that's been on the website. You know I had a word at the beginning there that if you would like for this service, you might want to have a candle lit in your worship area at home, or maybe a light, a small light. And then as we get to the end of the service and the Christ candle is carried out, you could extinguish your candle as well. Want to thank Chris and Linda Olson who are singing tonight, and Nick Fosheim who's playing, and Kenny Bathke, Paige Miller, and Jory Sorensen who are our readers and leading the service of shadows, and Brian Penn is in the booth. And know that we have one change in the bulletin that was on the website. Instead of a trio after, I think it's the fifth word, we're going to sing verses 3 and 4 of Ah, Holy Jesus. Then I would invite you to join us at 10:30 on Sunday morning for Facebook Live as we celebrate Easter. So 10:30 on Sunday morning. Again, welcome to worship this evening, and we begin by singing the hymn Beneath the Cross of Jesus. Let us pray. Almighty God, look with loving mercy on your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed, to be given over to the hands of sinners, and to suffer death on the cross, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And just a brief reflective word this evening on this Good Friday. We are in a Good Friday time. We are hiding out in our homes. Many are anxious and worried, fearful of sickness or death, loss of income or home. And I know many are grieving. Students and teachers, graduates who don't get to do spring senior year activities, or grieving a loss of companionship. We wear masks and gloves, unable to touch one another. We are in a Good Friday time when it seems that the shadow of death has grown deeper and more encompassing of us and of our world. So we know about the shadows that we are going to hear about this evening. We know about desertion, about fear, betrayal, agony, loneliness. And we may think that God has done all these things to us and wonder why. Why? We might ask with Jesus the question that he asked on this day from the cross. My God, why have you forsaken me? But God has not forsaken us. God is not punishing us. Indeed, God comes into the world in Jesus because of all these shadows. The world is not as God intends. It is broken by sin and death. And so God comes into the world to take care of those shadows. God comes into the world and goes straight at death. God goes to the cross. And on this day, when we are fully aware of the shadows, we know that this is not the last day. This day does not tell us the end of the story. In the words of Tony Campolo, a Baptist writer and preacher, he's got this great sermon. And he says throughout it, he says, it may be Friday, but Sunday's coming. We don't turn away from this day because we can't fully appreciate and celebrate Easter without Good Friday. Christ dies for us. Christ is buried for us. But we know that Sunday is coming. Through the cross, we know God's great love for us. Jesus enters into all the shadows that we experience in the brokenness of this life. Jesus enters into them, but makes his way through them, and God gives himself on the cross that we might live. Amen. And a brief ancient liturgy called the Procession of the Cross that reminds us of what the cross is about. Behold the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the whole world. O come, let us worship him. We glory in your cross, O Lord, and we praise your holy resurrection. For by your cross, joy has come into the world. May God be merciful and bless us. May the light of God's face shine upon us. Let your way be known upon the earth, your saving health among all nations. We glory in your cross, O Lord, and we praise your holy resurrection. For by your cross, joy has come into the world. Let the people praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. May God give us blessing, and may all the ends of the earth stand in awe. We glory in your cross, O Lord, and we praise your holy resurrection. For by your cross, joy has come into the world. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world. And we sing, Jesus, keep me near the cross.
Till The Shadow of Betrayal. When it was evening, he took his place with the 12, and while they were eating, he said, "Truly, I tell you, one of you will betray me." And then they became greatly distressed and began to say to him one after another, "Surely not I, Lord." He answered, "The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born." Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Surely not I, Rabbi." He replied, "You have said so."
The Shadow of Inner Agony. He came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him. When he reached the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not come into the time of trial." Then he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down, and prayed, "Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done." Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength. In his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground.
Go to dark Gethsemane, all who feel the tempter's power. Your Redeemer's conflict see, watch with him one bitter hour. Turn not from his griefs away, learn from Jesus Christ to pray. Follow to the judgment hall, view the Lord of life arraigned. Oh, the banquet and the gall, oh, the pangs his soul sustained. Shun not suffering, shame, or loss, learn from him to bear the cross.
The shadow of loneliness. Then he came to the disciples and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter, "So, could you not stay awake with me 1 hour? Stay awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." Again he went away for the second time and prayed, "My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done." Again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them again, he went away and prayed for the third time, saying the same words. Then he came to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners."
And care, draw near all that fold me, and ease the pain I bear. My hope lies bruised and battered, my wounded heart is torn, my spirit spent and shattered, my life's relentless storm. Will you not better hear me? My cries from deep within. Have you nowhere to cheer me when night is closing?
The shadow of desertion. While he was speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd with swords and clubs from the chief of priests and elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man, arrest him." At once he came up to Jesus and said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus said to him, "Friend, do what you are here to do." Then they came and laid hands on Jesus and arrested him. At that hour, Jesus said to the crowds, "Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But all this has taken place so that the scriptures of the prophets may be fulfilled." Then all the disciples deserted him and fled.
Thank you.
The shadow of accusation. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for false testimony against Jesus so that they might put him to death. But they found none, though many false witnesses came forward. At last, two came forward and said, "This fellow said, 'I am able to destroy the temple of God and to build it in 3 days.'" The high priest stood up and said, "Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against you?" But Jesus was silent. Then the high priest said to him, "I put you under oath before the living God. Tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of God." Jesus said to him, "You have said so, but I tell you, from now on, you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven." Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, "He has blasphemed. Why do we still need witnesses? You have now heard his blasphemy. What is your verdict?" They answered, "He deserves death." They spat in his face and struck him, and some slapped him, saying, "Prophesy to us, Messiah. Who is that struck you?"
The shadow of mockery. Pilate spoke to them again. "Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call the King of the Jews?" They shouted back, "Crucify him." Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him." So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas from them. And after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, and they called together the whole cohort. And they clothed him in a purple cloak, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him. And they began saluting him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him.
Thank you. in Jerusalem that day. The soldiers tried to clear the narrow street, but the crowd pressed in to see the man condemned to die on Calvary. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. And he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary. He was bleeding from a beating, there were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head. And he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. And he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary. The blood that would cleanse the souls of a man made its way through the heart of Jerusalem. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. And he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary.
The Shadow of Death. When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing. And the people stood by, watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There is also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he truly said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, while the sun's light failed and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." Having said this, he breathed his last.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble.